Well, hello, good morning. It's just gone 7 a.m. on Monday the 20th of February and I'm off on another youth hostel trip. I'm heading up to Wilderhope Manor in Shropshire. I'm not exactly sure if that's how you pronounce it. It could be Wilderhope. I think it's more likely to be Wilderhope. If they're friendly on the reception when I get there, I'll ask them to clarify. If not, I'll figure out some other way of deciding. So the route basically I'm following today is I'm doing my usual loop up the Severn Bridge. It skirts around the sort of edge of the outskirts of Bristol, up to Severn Bridge, over across the estuary to Chepstow. Then it's pretty much due north, all the way up the border to Bridge North. So I'm pretty much, if you can imagine, I'm running just the 10-15 miles to the left of the M5, heading direct north up to Bridge North. And then you start to make it into a 200 kilometre, then you start arcing over to the left to do sort of like a semi-circular route over to the hostel itself, you know, to make the distance up. It's in the Shropshire Hills, and I guess if you sort of think of a map of the UK, the latitude is round about the same as Wolverhampton, so it gives you an idea of where it is. But as usual, here's a picture of the map. Well, hello again and welcome to Twilight Zone. Actually, it's the M4. I'm actually on the Severn Bridge, and to give you an idea of how thick the fog is, there's where the cable's anchored. There's the cable going up to meet the first tower on the English side. You can't even see more than about halfway up the slope. So what happened was, it's very mild this morning. You can probably tell I've gone into a cap and I'm in fingerless gloves now. It's very mild, light as I said earlier on, till I got up to the A38, and then you cross over the A38 and drop down into, in effect, the southern end of the Barkley Vale, running alongside the Severn Estuary, and you can sort of see just how quickly the weather's changed. I'm sort of guessing it will improve as I climb out of Chepstow the other side as I gain some altitude. Well, that's quite nice. I've just come down through Chepstow, and although it's quite misty, as I went down the high street, it's almost like a little microclimate. It just changed. There's still mist, but it suddenly became warm mist. There was no moisture in it. It was actually quite cold where I was earlier on. Just stopped to do a picture on this bridge, and this lady stopped and I just stopped to set up a picture on the bridge. This is the bridge at the south of Chepstow, going over the River Wye. I'm just about to do a big climb up towards Colford, towards the Forest of Dean. And I sort of waved her through. I said, yeah, don't rest, take your time. She said, oh, you're doing the England-Wales game. And I sort of said, no. She sort of said, oh, because that's the border there. I've ridden over this bridge so many times, I sort of almost kicked myself for not knowing that. That's this bridge halfway across, exactly where my bike is the England-Wales border. So I've got 1 foot in England, 1 foot in Wales at the moment. So I just did a garage stop at Colford, just did a quick forecourt sugary snack and a can of orange, just starting to get a little bit low on energy. So climbed out of Colford up Berry Hill, across Berry Hill Turnpike, and now I'm just turning off left and I'm heading down towards Simon Jatt. I'm going to rejoin the River Wye and then be following that up for quite a few miles up to Ross-on-Wye. So maybe now's a good time to just sort of explain why I'm going to this youth hostel. On my 1400 kilometre DIY last year through Lindisfarne and back, this is pretty much the route I took on the first day, and I remember passing Wilderhope, however it's pronounced, the hostel, thinking, wow, that would be a really good place to come back to sometimes. So I've sort of been thinking about it for quite a long time. During the January sale, I was going through which hostels were available, and Wilderhope Hostel sprung up as a late addition. And even though it's now February, as long as you book them during the month of January, you could book and get the 25% discount on selected hostels right through till about early April. So that's the reason I'm going. I've been reading up a little bit about it. It's a Grade 1 listed in Elizabethan Manor, English Heritage Own It, and and I guess YHA must lease it for overnight accommodation. It's actually licensed to perform civil ceremonies. In fact, there's even a bridal suite there, so, you know, play me cards right, who knows where I'll end up tonight. So that's looking back at Simon Jack Rock. I've just come down quite a steep road, very narrow in places. Really like this. About 7 or 8 miles north of Ross-on-Wino. Starting to look for somewhere where I can have my lunch. Always quite like it when I get onto roads and I don't recognise any of the destinations, but I love this one, Trumpet Pixley. So it's 1 o'clock, I've just jumped into a bus shelter to have a little bit of scoff, so I bought some with me and also picked up a bottle of juice and a bargain bag of Heroes, giving my Garmin a quick sort of 10-15 minute charge, keep it going. Doing quite well for time, 1 o'clock, so that means I've been on the road since about 6 hours actually, so it's going to be about a 12 hour ride I expect. One of the things I've been loving about the winter hostelling is just something really nice about getting to a hostel in the dark, you know, it's after a 125 mile ride. Just the thought of the shelter is just, oh, just such an amazing buzz when you get there. And I am realising now with the days getting longer, probably going to be getting there at dusk rather than dark, so some of the magic is going to be wearing off. And once it does get a lot lighter in the evenings and warmer, I won't really want to be hosteling anyway. I'd rather be camping or bivvying or outdoors really. 2:10 and I'm on the road to Bromyard. I've just climbed up quite a big sort of ridge, onto a ridge. You can see the Black Mountains right in the far distance, very distinctive. So it's about 3:40 now and I'm really in the heart of the Black Country. It's actually got quite lumpy the last hour or so. I was struggling a little bit at the bottom of this hill. I had to just stop and get a quick sort of snack at my saddlebag. Gives you an idea of the scenery though, looking back. That's the way I've just come. Road snaking in the far distance. There's a church just on the left of it. I'm not sure if that comes out. There's some brick buildings down there that are oast houses by the look of it. So at the moment I keep seeing signs for Staraport on Severn. I don't actually go through that. Sort of next big stop is Bridgnorth. I'll try and pick up some supplies there. What I normally bring with me, I'll maybe show it in the kitchen tonight, I always bring a tub of margarine, just a small Tupperware full of margarine that I just scoop out at home. I don't want a full tub. And just a small bag of pasta, so I just put them both in plastic bags, you know, I can dispose of them afterwards. And then I normally pick up a tin of something like curry or chili con carne, something like that, just to sort of beef it up. I won't be buying beer on the road today because there's actually licensed premises at the hostel and it's just a little bit unfair to sort of go there and drink my own beer. In fact, I think it's actually against the rules, to be honest. But it's 7 p.m. and I've got my wish. I'm actually going to be arriving at the hostel in the dark. I'm about 8 miles to go. I've just stopped in the village of Muchwenlock. It's really nice here actually. This afternoon the ride's been quite hard actually, very undulating, sort of like long fast downhills and long drags up the other side. It's been like that sort of constantly for about 50 miles. Scenery's been really good. Bridgnorth was really nice, sort of like sunset, that was really nice. Heard the whistle of a steam engine as I went by the Severn Valley Railway, although I didn't see one. Makes me want to come back actually. So yeah, about 8 miles to the hostel now. just suddenly realised I didn't have any bread or rolls, so I popped in this spa to get some, loaded up some chocolate goodies for the night as well, just in case I get the munchies. So yeah, quite looking forward to getting there now. So I'm just turning left off a lane into the youth hostel area. I remember passing this so vividly last year on my Lindisfarne trip, but it's nice, there's an old triangle YHA sign there actually. Well, I've made it, what a place. Just coming up to 5 to 8, so nearly another 13 hour old outside. So after leaving Wenlock, picked up some food, quite a long sort of gradual climb up onto an escarpment, wooded escarpment, and you've got these amazing views of, on the left hand side, you know, the last rays of daylight. Yeah, looked like quite a drawn out sunset actually. It really felt very springy. And on the right hand side, dropping down, you sort of see all this like urban lighting. I imagine it's like the M5 corridor somewhere in Birmingham, Wolverhampton. I'll have to look it up on a map. Then gradually sort of did a curve away from that and it sort of disappeared into the distance. And then just looking down, it's all this like sparkly sort of lights. So I'm going to go in and check in now. Can't wait just to get out to my dorm, get stripped down, in a shower, and get some food. So yeah, it's very grand here actually. This is the dining room. Just cooking myself a meal. Got myself a pint at the bar. So it looks like, as well as youth hostel visitors, they also cater for educational groups as well. So there's sort of like some families here with their children. Got to admit, I'm so hungry. I'm just so looking forward to my tea in a minute. Well, hello, good morning. It's Tuesday the 21st of February, about 10 to 9. Just had a really good night's sleep. Nice big hearty breakfast, and I'll be leaving soon. I'm not doing a 200 kilometre DIY back to Bath today. I did consider it, and frankly I just can't be arsed. It's just a fairly direct route, still going to be about 104 miles, so I've got quite a long day in front of me. But just before we go, a little outside view of the hostel. So once again, I booked it through the January sale. As long as you booked hostels in the January sale, you could get the discounts right through till about early April, Easter I guess. So this one with the 25% discount, 10% discount off a pre-booked breakfast, and my £3 membership discount, it's £15.68. So just trying to sort of imagine how much it would cost to stay in a hotel. So I'm back at the entrance to Wilderhope Manor, just about to head off home now. But this is the route that I came from yesterday. So I came in from the north because I'd looped up to add the extra distance on to make it into a 200 kilometre ride. That is the direction I'm going to be leaving in today, and that's the direction I passed last year on the Lindisfarne trip. And I just remember seeing it thinking, I have to go there one day, it looks really nice. And it was as well. An old traditional triangle YHA sign, bike all loaded up for the day. So the really nice lady who checked me in last night, very friendly, she could see I was quite tired. She cooked my breakfast meal this morning as well, very friendly. I actually asked her how it's pronounced, and she sort of said some people Wilderhope, others Wilderhope. She said most of the locals call it Wilderhope. Seems more natural to me. I find that easier to pronounce, so it's Wilderhope as far as I'm concerned. So I just checked my Garmin. It's about 103 miles to get to home. I'm going to be on my way now, so as usual, thanks for watching and till next time.